Hello students, this is our chapter number 3, quality of irrigation water, and this is our lecture number 5. So our point is, today's point is water quality standard. So what is water quality standard? After analyzing or analysis of water sample for different parameters like total salts, cations, anions, it is very essential to calculate some indices in order to assess water quality and its subsequent effect on soil. So important indices of water quality parameters are given below. Those parameters are total soluble salts, that is TSS, then second one is sodium adsorption ratio, that is SAR, then third parameter is exchangeable sodium percentage, that is ESP, then fourth one is residual sodium carbonate, that is RSC, then fifth parameter is salinity classes for irrigation water, this is fifth parameter. So these are parameters which is used, or these are important indices of water quality parameters. Okay, so we will discuss in details. So first one, total soluble salt, that is TSS. What is TSS? Total concentration of soluble salts in the most important criteria of quality of irrigation water, because salinity of soil or salinity of soil solution is usually related to the salinity of irrigation water. That's why this total soluble salts are salts, or the concentration of soluble salts is most important criteria. Then total concentration of soluble salt is expressed as electrical conductivity. It is expressed in the terms of electrical conductivity. The electrical conductivity through the solution is related to the ion numbers, the electrical charges and mobility. The rate of which electricity is conducted is a measure of ion activity in the solution, and electrical conductivity is expressed as moles, that is reciprocal of ohms per centimeter. Okay. For natural water, electrical conductivity value is much less than 1 unit. Therefore, for convenience, these values are reported as millimoles per centimeter. Okay. So electrical conductivity serves as a guide to know the extent of soluble salt which is present in the irrigation water. So in this chart, or in this table number 3.5.1, the suitability of water with different constituents for irrigation is shown. So here it is, first part of this chart is class of water, then TDS in ppm, then sulfate in ppm, then chloride in ppm. TDS is total dissolved salts, then chlorides in ppm, then percentage sodium, then boron ppm. Okay, then electrical conductivity in millimoles, then suitability for irrigation. So TDS, if water contains 0 to 700 TDS, then sulfate is 0.0 to 192 ppm, chloride is 0 to 142 ppm, and percentage sodium is 0 to 60%, and boron is 0 to 0.5 ppm, and the electrical conductivity for the irrigation water is 0 to 750. Okay, then suitability for irrigation is excellent to good for irrigation. So that type of water is excellent to good for irrigation. If TDS is 700 to 2000 ppm, sulfate is 192 to 480 ppm, chloride is 142 to 355 ppm, and percentage sodium is 60 to 75%, and boron is 0.5 to 2.0 ppm, and electrical conductivity of that water is 750 to 2250 millimoles. So that type of water is good to injurious injurious suitable only with permeable soil and moderate leaching harmful to sensitive crops. Okay, so this is suitability of the irrigation. And next one is, third one is 2000 TDS ppm. Sulfate percentage is, sulfate is 480 ppm, chloride is 355 ppm, and percentage sodium is less than 75%, and boron is also 2.0%, and electrical conductivity is also more less than 2250. So that type of water is unfit for irrigation. So here it is chart for total soluble salts like TSS. So our next point is sodium absorption ratio, that is SAR. So what is sodium absorption ratio? With regards to the quality of water for irrigation, the major parameters to concern are salinity, denoted by dissolved solids, and conductivity, potentially toxic elements and herbicides. In addition, the presence of sodium in water, that is tendency of irrigation water to form exchangeable sodium in the soil, means it is the presence of sodium in water is the sodium absorption ratio, that is SAR. So these parameters can be calculated by following formula. Here we can see a formula which is used to calculate the sodium absorption ratio or SAR. Okay, so with the help of this SAR we can calculate, or with the help of this formula we can calculate percentage of sodium, that is percentage of sodium is equal to Na plus divided by Ca2 plus plus Mg2 plus plus K plus plus Na plus into 100. So by using this formula you can calculate the percentage of sodium, and what is SAR, that is sodium absorption ratio, is equal to Na plus divided by under root Ca2 plus plus Mg2 plus divided by 2. So we can calculate SAR or sodium absorption ratio. Okay, so this is our next point, that is sodium absorption ratio. Now third point is suitability of water for irrigation with different values of SAR rating. Here it is chart. In this chart we can see the suitability of water for irrigation. So if SAR means, now we can understand how to calculate SAR. SAR, the formula to calculate the SAR is equal to sodium plus divided by under root Ca2 plus plus Mg2 plus divided by 2. So with the help of this formula we can calculate SAR, that is sodium absorption ratio, and according to this ratio, if the SAR which is present to 0 to 10 milliequivalent per liter in that water, then that type of water is suitable for all types of crops and all types of soil except for those crops which are highly sensitive to sodium. Okay, so this is safe ratio or safe SAR ratio in irrigation water. Okay, then if SAR is 10 to 18 milliequivalent per liter, then that type of soil is suitable for coarse texture or organic soil with good permeability, relatively unsuitable in fine textured soil. So that soil is moderately safe soil. And when SAR is more than SAR is up to 18, it is about 18 to 26 milliequivalent per liter, then that soil is harmful for almost all types of soils. Okay, and required, almost all types of soils required good drainage, high leaching and gypsum addition. And if SAR is more than 26 or it is more than 26 milliequivalent per liter, then it is unsuitable, that soil is that water is unsuitable for irrigation, and that is unsafe for irrigation purpose. Okay, so that type of water is unsafe because the SAR means sodium absorption ratio in that water is more than 26. Okay, so we can see the SAR ratio and the suitability of irrigation water. In our next point, this is trace elements limits for irrigation water in milligram per liter used continuously for crops. So here it is also one chart which contains trace elements like aluminium, arsenic, boron, cadmium, chromium, cobalt and copper, and limit in milligram per liter. That elements limits for irrigation water in milligram per liter used continuously for crops. So there are elements, like there are 13 elements: lead, manganese, molybdenum, nickel, selenium and zinc is also there, and there the limits of that elements are also there. So limits are, here it is a chart. In this chart there are trace elements with their limits in milligram per liters. Okay. So for irrigation water, quality point of view analysis of water generally related with determination of EC, pH water, soluble pH, water soluble cations and anions. Okay. So in our next point, we will discuss exchangeable sodium percentage, that is ESP. What is ESP? ESP is scale. It is included to establish relationship with SAR, determining water quality. Both are positively correlated. Okay. The United States, in the United States, Salinity Laboratory established an empirical formula to predict the ESP of soil. It is ESP, that is exchangeable sodium percentage, which is in the United States Salinity Laboratory established an empirical formula to predict that exchangeable sodium percentage, that is ESP. So formula is as you can see, the formula ESP is equal to 100 into bracket minus 0.0126 plus 0.01475 SAR divided by 1 plus into bracket minus 0.0126 plus 0.01475 SAR. What is SAR again? SAR is sodium absorption ratio. On the basis of cation exchange equilibrium for sodium, calcium, magnesium, system of 5 different soils in India, the ESP is calculated as this formula. The second formula is ESP is equal to 100 into 0.23 plus 0.0042 SAR divided by 1 plus into bracket 0.23 plus 0.0042 SAR. This was found more applicable. Okay, so here we can see the exchangeable sodium percentage or the formula to calculate the ESP. Now our next point is, our next parameter is RCS, that is residual sodium carbonate. So what are residual sodium carbonate? That calcium reacts with bicarbonate and precipitates as a CaCO3. As a calcium and magnesium are lost from water, relative proportion or relative proportion of sodium increases, and hence sodium hazard, that sodium is hazardous. That's why this hazard can be evaluated as residual sodium carbonate. When residual sodium carbonate is calculated, the formula for the calculation of residual sodium carbonate is given here, where concentration of both cations and anions in milliequivalent per liter, then sodicity hazards in terms of RSC is categorized in a given table. So here it is table. When RSC, what is RSC? Residual sodium carbonate, carbonate which is present in milliequivalent per liter, when it is less than 1.25, it is safe and excellent. Okay, when it is 1.25 to 250, it is moderate and good to moderate. So here we can see RSC value for different water samples and the suitability class of that water. Okay, so this type of water are suitable, safe, moderate or unsafe for crop production. We can see this criteria like RSC, residual sodium carbonate. Then our next point is classification and zoning of water bodies. So what are classification and zoning of water bodies? That is salinity classes for irrigation water. What are salinity classes? Water quality objectives for fresh water take into account several major uses which water is put like irrigation. So which type of water is put like irrigation, drinking, industry, power generation, etc. This had led to the concept of classification and zoning of that water, which indicates that their quality has to meet the requirements of one or more of the potential users. The water resources can be classified or zoned depending upon the designated best use of the water and the Central Pollution Control Board along with State Pollution Control Board has adopted the classification and zoning of water bodies. So here we can see classification and zoning of water bodies, that is water bodies in this chart or in this table. Here it is this designated best use of fresh water and nomenclature for class of water. So here we can see chart. In this chart, first part contains drinking water sources without conventional treatment but after disinfection. It is class 1 or first class type of drinking water. The second type of water is outdoor bathing water, that is class B or second class of drinking water. Then third one is drinking water source with conventional treatment followed by disinfection, that is class C or third class type. Then it is nomenclature for classes. Then propagation of wildlife or fisheries, it is class D or fourth class. And irrigation, industrial, cooling and controlled waste disposal, the water which is used for irrigation, industrial purpose, cooling and controlled waste disposal belongs to class E or fifth class. So here it is classification and zoning of different types of water bodies according to their needs. Then in our next chart we will discuss water quality criteria for fresh water classification. Here we can see class A, B, C, D, E and dissolved oxygen percentage, BOD, MPN, then caliform per 100 ml. So here it is a chart to describe the water quality criteria for fresh water and its classification. From all above study of fresh water used for irrigation purpose, the quality of irrigation water should qualify the guidelines of Central Pollution Control Board, that is CPCB, and State Pollution Control Board. So such water is used for irrigation purpose, it gives good crop yields. Therefore, finally we summarize the guidelines that are available to evaluate quality of water for irrigation. So water can be classified in 5 classes depending upon its chemical proportion or chemical properties. Okay, not proportion, its chemical properties. So here it is one chart which describes quality of water for irrigation and that classes depending upon its chemical properties. Okay, so if that water contains more than 20% sodium, then SAR value, EC value and RAC value, then that type of water is excellent water. So here second column there is good water, which is sodium percentage is 20 to 40, EC is 250 to 750, then SAR it is 10 to 18 milliequivalent per liter and RAC is 1.25 to 2. This is good water. Then medium type of water is 40 to 60 sodium, 750 to 2250, EC 18 to 26 SAR and 2 to 2.5 RAC. Then 60 to 80% of sodium, that type of water is bad water, it is not good for crops. So that is very bad or harmful water. Then RAC is also 2.5 to 3 for that water. Then very bad quality water is that water is more than 80% of sodium and 400 EC, 26 SAR and 3 RAC. So that type of water is bad water. Here it is also a chart to determine the quality of water for irrigation. So in this chapter we already have discussed the micronutrients, all nutrients, these are all constituents, their functions, which is the classes of that nutrients, like major constituents, minor constituents, and water quality standards. There are different five parameters to parameters of water quality standards, that total soluble salts, sodium absorption ratio, that is SAR, then residual sodium carbonate, that is RSC, exchangeable sodium percentage, that is EST, and salinity classes for irrigation water. So these are some parameters to determine the quality of that irrigation water. So we already have completed this chapter. Now in our next chapter, is chapter number 4, plant nutrients. In our next lecture we will discuss about that chapter number 4, that is plant nutrients. Okay, thank you so much for your cooperation.